Welcome back everyone to the HWBOT World Series 2016 Latin America, and this is the bronze match to define who will be third and fourth in this qualifier here in Campus Party in Sao Paulo, Brazil. I'm being joined by Dan Kopp from Germany, he's number one overclocker in the world so far, and will be commenting with me the match between these two guys, Joe9TBR and Noms. And I think that everyone is now ready, they're waiting to do the draw. Let's get into the communication with Massman, the judge. Massman, can you hear us?
Sure.
Okay, so what will happen is they will choose one of the benchmark, and each overclocker have one veto.
All right. So
what will
guys,
be the first one?
What do you want to veto? You want to no GPU Pi?
No GPU Pi, no memory.
All right. So it's gotta be okay. W prime 32M. Okay.
So they will be benching W prime 32M like Joe9TBR against AC Shanks had in the first round. This will be interesting to see because Joe9TBR already knows his system and how much he can do with this. We'll be ready to launch this new match in the next few seconds. Dan Kopp, are you ready?
Yes.
Let's get ready. Let's check with the overclocker if they are ready.
Peter,
Yuri, is everyone ready? So we go live for this round in 3, 2, 1,
go.
This is it. They have 30 minutes in this round to do the best W prime 32M score. On the left of the screen, you can see Joe9TBR from Brazil, of course. And on the right side of the screen, you can see Noms. They are fighting to know who will be third and who will be the last of this competition today.
Yeah, I think JoeBR has a small advantage.
Because he already did the benchmark in the run before?
Yeah, yes. He did it already. I think he knows some things he didn't know before. Maybe some guys told him what to do right now. And yeah.
So let's switch back to their screen. This is the screen of Joe9TBR.
I think currently he's waiting for the temperature to get low enough.
Other side of the screen, Noms right now. Charging his profile. We profile 2 for XMP. And then 29.33 multiplier divided.
Yes, and Noms is starting with 5.5 on the CPU. So I think the best score in the semifinal was with a 5.550. So Noms is starting with 5.5 right now. Should be very close to the best score of W prime in the semifinals. Now he's playing with a voltages, now the ring voltage, 1.4 volts. System agent, he's going to plus 250 on the IO analog and digital.
He went straight to 2.3 volts for the VCC in, so he knows already what the CPU can do. I'm not sure if he got the exact same CPU he had in the run before. I don't think so. I think they remix and redraw the CPU after.
But he was just playing the max memory clock.
Yep.
So we don't know the CPU right now.
The CPU is a 4770K, but we don't know if it's exactly the same one he was playing with just before for the max memory.
Ah, okay. So they changed the CPU between the benchmarks.
Yep.
Okay.
So, as you can see, there is a massive crowd watching what the guys doing.
Wow.
We're here at the campus party. This is actually insane to see that many people that we love it and these people are interested in what's going on.
I saw some groupies.
These guys are professional. They do that a lot of the time, most of the time during the week they do this. Consider using liquid nitrogen, on the right side NOMS, on the left side Jona and TBR, and in the middle you have Yuri from HyperX checking for the time.
Yeah, there we are in the BIOS again. And what is he doing? Cooling down the CPU. I mean, 4 minutes are gone. Usually you have to bench 4770K around minus 100 to minus 130, depends on the cold pack of the CPU.
But in the first round, when Jona and TBR was already playing on W32M, it was not going lower than minus 80. It was having some cold bug issue.
Yeah. I've heard it. It should be. I think it was around 80, 81. Yeah, like you said. Maybe the CPU has that cold bug around minus 80, but maybe he can figure out some other timings. I think he's not at the limit.
That's what we will see in the next few minutes. We have a connection live with Xiala on the he's very close to the overclockers right now. So Xiala, how is it going at this moment?
It's going quite well from what I can see. It's a bit less stressful, I think, than before. Well, careful with my cable.
And blue screen!
There we have another one!
Yeah, so they're both running around minus 77 degrees, minus 80 degrees. Seems no one is having too many issues at the moment. Smiling, all good, less stressful, definitely. I think they're getting used to the format.
Jamie is always smiling.
Yeah, and that is true. He's a funny guy, as you can see. And I think he's quite confident as well for this run because the run before, he was already benching W32M. So let's see the screen of NOMS going back into the BIOS. During that time, Jona and TBR is still rebooting, experiencing some blue screen. So this is it. He's setting the default, he's setting manually the timings to not have the system to choose them automatically. Would that be a good way to do it, Dankop?
Yes, sometimes it is, indeed. Sometimes the system knows more than you. Because the outer settings usually give you the best voltages, frequencies you need for PWMs, and so on. But if you are at the very limit of the CPU or the memories or whatever, then you have to play with it. But before, I try on auto, usually.
Which some of the settings for the memory voltages. As you can see, they are not using the UEFI BIOS, they're using the old way of doing it.
Yeah, that's normal. I think nobody likes the 3D BIOS with some bling bling here and bling bling there. It looks good, but if you want to act fast, you like the old scheme of a BIOS.
This is it. There is a blue screen at NOMS as well. Blue screen! Saving the configuration for Jona and TBR, rebooting the system. Timothy, how is the tension right now with the contestant?
Well, Joe seems to be still relaxed. NOMS, I guess, a little bit less. You can feel he's quite stressed. I think the fact that he had to change motherboard stressed him out a little bit. And now time is slowly running out. Slowly.
Oh no, he was setting 2.4. It's not working. He was setting 2.4 and didn't apply. It went back to auto all the time.
What kind of boards are they using? I mean, Gigabyte, okay.
Yeah,
but which one?
NOMS is using the D3H. Gigabyte, okay. D3H. And so Jaime Joe 9TBR is using the SoC board.
So the D3H might be limiting it around 2.3.
It might be, yes.
Could be. But I don't think yet they need more. 2.3 is a lot.
Blue screen.
And another blue screen.
Oh, we catch it last second on the live. Joe 9TBR restarting Windows again, trying to get in. It is interesting to see WPrime32M because it's extremely fast benchmark. So it takes less than 5 seconds to run. Actually, Joe 9TBR is already at 4.4 seconds for this benchmark.
Yeah, and currently he's acting around 5.2 on the CPU.
I just wish the interface of W Prime was be would be using a bigger font.
So as you can see, the voltage for the memory is at 1.75, while the V9 and the V-Core is 1.6. 5.2 gigahertz right now, trying to reach 5.3. 5.3. 5.3.
Franglish.
That's the Franglish kicking in.
Franglish, yeah. Gesundheit.
Did run the benchmark. 1, 2, 3, 4. Get the score. 4.37.
437.
This is improving the score of 4.4.
So you can see that the guys are benching standing now. I don't know if you noticed.
They were sitting for the previous one.
Yeah, at least Joe was sitting all the time, so he seems he really wants to get that third place.
Do you think he's nervous?
I don't know. It's hard to tell. I think he's getting more nervous now.
Joe is relaxed all the time.
That's how it is in Brazil. 1, 2, 3. Here we go.
Wow.
4.41, but it's not improving its score. Yeah. 4.41. It's trying to reach the BCLK, the base clock frequency. A little bit more than 100.
CPU frequency is at 22?
I think even you guys on the live can see better than me from where I am. The pixels are too far away.
And sadly, it crashed at 5.3. Was trying to use the 101 MHz of base clock. This is going to be a new try for him. During that time, we have Noms that tried to reboot the system. Sadly, the time was 4.112, but it crashed at the end. So I'm not sure if this valid score or not, as long as the judge saw it. We can see that Joe9TBR and Noms are just both have the exact same score so far. Let's see what Noms will do. Going to the GTL software. Adjusting to 4054 for the core multiplier. That means 5.4 gigahertz for the CPU. W prime.
If it runs, we have a new lead. I guess. Let's see.
Mark, run the benchmark. That would be less than 5 seconds.
2, 3.
And blue screen!
Blue screen!
That's the most epic blue screen ever. Right before finishing the benchmark. It's really, yeah, I don't want to say right now.
There's a question from Jumper118 on the live chat. No tweaks, are they allowed to tweak? Yes, they're allowed to tweak, but they have to keep in mind that they should not break the system, because if they break the system, it is over for them. There's no swappable system for it. So that's it. Yes, it's kind of like the goal commentary here in Brazil, like goal, 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 when there's a blue screen in overclocking.
Goal, goal, goal. Very good. Very good.
Okay, here we go. Let's go check Noms. It puts 9 instead of 8 for the number of threads. Is that a new tweak? 4.47, not enough to... Oh, seems it crashed. Indeed, it is a crash. It crashed. It tried to do the benchmark, and it's a blue screen again.
Let's see, we have a 1-1. Now, Joe.
Joe 9 TBR.
3. Ah. And that's a blue screen.
Sadly, none of them managed to pass the benchmark completely without having a blue screen.
Is it right? Both have 437?
I think it is, yeah.
Damn, that's tight. Cool.
Starting the system. You can see that Nubs is already inside. He's benching at almost 4.3 gigahertz. Setting up W prime. 8 thread to make sure that all the core are being used. Adjusting the V-core to 1.625. Maybe you want to chase for the 5.4 gigahertz. And this is it. That's what he's doing. Chasing for the 5.4 gigahertz. Trying this little bit increase of PCLK. Maybe that will be enough for him to the benchmark and get into the lead. That's core. Let's see what he will do. Make sure that... Right.
2, 3.
Goes, yes! 4 and 3.9 seconds. So that is not better than what he did just before. But still a nice score so far. Maybe see if he's trying to reach out on that.
Do we have a chance to see the temperatures they are?
We should ask Timothy now, because I cannot see them from here. I was supposed to be able to see them on the camera, but I can't. But I guess they are around between like -180 and -100. We will ask them at the end of this run. Joe9TBR is still in the lead with 4 seconds and 3.21 milliseconds. You can see he's benching quite fast. He knows exactly where he want to go. Around him, you see the other extreme overclockers. Looking at it, checking what he's doing. Oh, this is it. This is tweaking now. He will go select W prime, define the priority in real time. But is this really applied to a W prime, because it's actually spreading on multiple threads?
No, it's not.
So this actually tweak is not one. You should do one with the WMI call or something, I guess.
Yes. W prime is running some prime sequences in the background, of the wrapper itself. So if you apply real time for the wrapper, you don't apply real time for the separate instances who are calculating the score.
But that means that won't change the score at all.
Right. So it's not applying.
A false tweak, maybe it's a false lead for his open, and it's a crash. Let's go to Noms. He just did 4 seconds and 340 milliseconds. He's benching a little bit higher than 5.4 gigahertz.
He's right close again. He's very close.
There are 0.0 and 1 point difference.
2, 3.
Exact same score again.
Exact same.
No improvement.
So Joe Biar is back in OS, playing with the VCC in.
I think that time Noms is benching. That will be it for a 4.258. This is taking the lead for Noms. He was behind Jonah and TBR until now, and about 20 minutes after the beginning of this round, is finally taking up the lead in there and to win the bronze medal in this competition.
And we only have 11 minutes left, so it's getting interesting right now. I think Joe BR will play with a multiplayer right now.
You can see, he's still, Jaime, Jonah, TBR, is still smiling, but he's looking what the his opponent have made, and now there's like more than 0.80. Sorry guys, but the blue screen just appeared on Noms' screen. He had to reboot again. So they are both restarting their setup at the moment. They have to go into the BIOS, change some settings. So it seems that I had some issue with my mic. I hope that this is better now. This might be because of the noise gate and the noise cancelling issue right here, because it's extremely noisy here. We can barely talk to each other when we are like across the tables.
The guys in the background just seem to have fun.
Oh, okay, I have to speak loudly because the noise is kicking. Okay, so this is it. We have Jonah and TBR that just set up some of the stuff in the BIOS. On the other side, we have each of the overclockers that are waiting to restart their system. On the right side, you can see Noms. On the left side, you can see Jonah and TBR. There is less than 10 minutes left, and so far, Noms is the leader of this round. Will Jonah and TBR catch him up with few more megahertz and less few seconds? We will know in the next few minutes. Da-da-da.
And it's just 63, is it right? 63 milliseconds. So it's not that much.
And we'd like to thank Alejandro99 for the follow. Thank you very much. As you guys can hear, there's a lot of background noise here at the campus party in Sao Paulo, Brazil. This is a huge event, and we are here covering the AWBOT World Series for the Extreme guys. And right now we have Noms trying to reboot the system, and Jonah and TBR on the left side of the screen as well trying to restart the system. They have less than 8 minutes and 15 seconds left in this competition. That will be interesting to see what they can do.
Yeah, it's really interesting. It is 63 milliseconds only, the difference. So just, I think, a 10 to 20 megahertz on the CPU should decide who will win this bronze final. Both of them are booting currently, I think.
The guys are still rebooting the system. None of them managed to go into the OS so far. Let's see what... Oh, there's some glitch going on here. Something is wrong with the graphic card of Noms. That was great. We can catch that on the live.
That's a typical issue if you have humidity on the GPU. But the thing is, they are not overclocking the GPU. So
we have to note that actually Noms have a special graphic card. It's a completely modified graphic card. So maybe that's
really?
That was the reason. Yeah. I don't exactly know what is the exact reference he's using. Well, that was actually quite fun to be on the live.
But even Joe BR is not getting into Windows, it seems.
None of them are getting into Windows at this point. You can see there's a major crowd looking for what is happening right here at the campus party in Sao Paulo, Brazil.
There seem to be a lot of issues, I think, with humidity. Both of the guys were benching. Noms did it 30 minutes ago, and Joe BR 1 hour ago. So it could be due to the heating up the system. There is a little bit more humidity on the board. They want to have. The ports were running at -100 to -110 or -120 for 30 minutes for the semifinals, and then they had to take their system away to another spot, and now they have to bench again. During the time, all the ice on the pot went down to the motherboard. But not as ice, more like water.
Noms is struggling to get into Windows. Jonah and Tibera didn't manage for the past 3 minutes to actually get into OS, so he's trying to go back into the BIOS, change some of the settings, and see if everything is still okay with his SSD and the operating system on it. Make sure that everything is right. Playing the multiplier, I think it will go for 23 something. 28 now directly. That's gonna be a nice start. Let's see if this will boot finally on the OS. So this is it. Both of the overclockers are now restarting their system. As you can see, the two screens are black. There is less than 4 minutes in this bronze match for the HWBOT World Series 2016. On the right side of the screen, you have Jonah and TBR, and the left side of the screen, you have Noms. So far, Noms is still in the lead, and those score are there for more than 7 minutes. So that means that almost one fourth of the time, They didn't put any more any better score, so they are all struggling to get into. Jonah and TBR is back on Windows, adjusting the settings.
Joe BR is back, so let's have a look. No blue screen, but a crash.
That is a sad crash.
So try it again. Now let's have a look at the settings. So he's loading a profile. He just set the profile before. 1.6 volts, and 5350 on the CPU, adjusting the threads, Starting the benchmark. 1, 2, 3. Ah, there's a blue screen.
And yes, they are so close to the limit that the blue screen is kicking on. But that's it. Joe9TVR have 1 minute and 42 seconds left until the end of this match. And to beat the score of 4.28 seconds by Noms, if you want to finish third and not last of this competition. That would be interesting to see what Joe9TBR did do, because he was at the HOT, the HyperX OC Takeover, in early December, something you can find back on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/overclockingTV. And he was competing there at the very high level. And here we can see that Noms is actually taking on the nerves of Joe9TBR. He still have a kind of his smile, but I'm not quite sure he's really that happy to finish last in this final.
Nobody is happy to finish last, but actually he's not last. There was a qualifier before. 2, 3. That was close.
Just a few milliseconds away, starting to run the, and the blue screen!
Okay, Truth, you won it due to the lag I have. Otherwise, I would have been faster. No.
There's only 15 seconds left in this bronze round, and that seems to be almost the end.
Joe BR is in the
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. No, that's too late.
That's it.
That is too late. It's too bad. So this is it. The winner for this round is Noms. So Noms finished third of this competition, while Joe9TBR finished fourth in this competition final. This is well done and well made by the guys. This was a tough battle that was very close. Joe9TBR was in the lead most of the time. Like more than one third of the time he was in the lead, while Noms catch him up and submit one score that was better than him. And Joe9TBR never managed to catch up on that. So Dan Kopper, what was your thought about the this round of the bronze?
They had a lot of issues after 15 minutes. Was it 15 or 17 minutes? They had, I have no idea, something like humidity or moisture, whatever. They were playing in the BIOS or had some several issues with the boot itself. So, it was really, really tough for them to get into the OS to do some things.
I heard that we will have some information from the judge, Peter Massman, live with us. Can you hear us now?
Yeah, sure.
So what did happen during that match?
Well, we can talk about that later. Schenkel and PXHX are setting up right now for the final, and we'll start in about 5 minutes as well.
So this is going straight to the grand final now. That is great. We won't have to wait much. So that will be impressive to say. So you see Joe9TBR finishing to unplug his setup and moving back to his desk. So Schenkel and Peshigashi, yes, I find that Peshigashi will be fighting for a ticket to the world final of the HWBOT World Championship. So, Danko, Peshigashi. So, what do you expect from this upcoming match, my dear Danko?
Let's see what benchmark they do. Who knows? If it's, I'd like to see Max Memory Clock again, because that's really intense. I think really intense.
I would actually love to see Cinebench.
You want to see Cinebench? Okay.
It's a nice benchmark. It's quite fun to watch. So.
Yeah, sure. It takes a little bit longer. So the contestants need to be fast with the highest clocks. Who knows? We'll see. We'll see. The draw will decide.
But that's the thing. They have two veto, and usually they veto for GPU Pi. and the second one is usually XU. So maybe that will be Freedomark 11 Physics or Cinebench R11.5.
Yeah, what do you think? Will they veto?
I think they will veto GPU Pi for sure, because everyone have been doing that one since the beginning. And yeah. I guess they will veto XCU as well.
XCU as well. Yeah, sure. Nobody knows the memories. Yeah, you might be right.
But this is my only opinion as a caster and not as an extreme overclocker. And you already told us that you would veto GPU Pi anyway if you were in this kind of situation.
Yeah, sure, because it's the 100M version, not the 1B version. The 1B version would be around 5 to 6 minutes, and the 100M version would be much, much, much longer. So that's, yeah, not really good for 30 minutes of contest.
So they will be soon doing the draw of the benchmark after having to veto on the benchmark that they can. They will be fighting for the world a ticket for the world championship to happen in Berlin, Germany in December. The Edge of Robot World Championship is actually the biggest competition so far, with live qualifier in 6 different countries, 5 different continents, and 1 huge world championship.
Yes, and it's in Berlin. I mean, in the past,
we can do the drawing.
So this is it. Peter Massman will do the draw of the benchmark. They will have to veto on what they want. Let's make sure that everything is ready. Peter, up
okay.
to you.
Clayton, which benchmark do you veto? No memory clock. Okay. Paolo's veto benchmark? No 3D mark and no memory clock. No memory clock and no. All right.
So the benchmark for today will be.
It's W prime again. W prime 32M.
Oh my God! Oh my
Peter,
God! No,
Peter,
you have it again.
Bring the bag here. We want to check if it's all if it's all good.
It's only W prime in this bag. No, I'm just kidding.
So I have the bag with me. We'll be checking live with you guys. That of course there is not only W prime 32M in there. That is actually quite crazy. So the guys are almost ready to go. Just want to make sure that we have the timing to go in the next. So let's adjust what we need to have.
Truffy just got a sign. We can call Ishiagashi as Paolo. Or
Paolo.
Paolo. Paolo.
Oh, it's inverted. Wait. So we're just checking the last few things, make sure that everything will be all right. Just adjust a few settings. And Paolo. So this is it. This is now ready. They have 30 minutes. We'll be launching that once we have the go from the judge. Are the overclockers okay? Okay. So we go in 3, 2, 1,
go.
So this is it. They have 30 minutes to do the best score in W prime 32M. Thank you, Krumi. My GTA for the follow. I really appreciate that. That is fun. There's a lot of people on the live chat. Say hi to Steponzi and Der Bauer. Der Bauer from Germany and Steponzi from the US. That is nice to see you guys over here. So this is the HWBOT World Series Championship. This is the Latin America qualifier. And these two people, Paolo on the left and Clayton on the right, have to be the best to win a ticket for the HWBOT World Championship Final that will happen in Germany in December 2016. Let's get into the action. Clayton is already in the bio setting at 2.2 volt for the VR. VR in the and 1.59 for the CPU.
Now we see he's adjusting exactly the same settings he had before. So I think he's quite experienced in the benchmark right now, especially with this platform. So yeah, it's going to be interesting who will be the first guy with the first score, and at last who will be the fastest.
Yeah, trying to what's going on, maybe thinking a little bit more about what he will be doing. I think he's checking his notes on what he will do. Waiting for the temperature to drop on the CPU.
Are notes allowed?
Yeah, they can take notes. They just cannot install anything on the system, but they can take notes if they want.
Okay, cool. But stuff like a smartphone for some hints from other guys, is that allowed also?
Sure, it's kind of like taking notes on paper, but with a smartphone. But that's the thing. You have 30 minutes to do your best score. You don't have the time to mess around, trying to speak with your friends, etc. And there's huge delay. Even if your friends are watching over Twitch, there's a huge delay, about 2 to 3 minutes. In this kind of time competition with 30 minutes maximum, it is something you cannot try to do it. It's going to be way too dangerous for you to rely on someone else to do it. You better be good.
Yeah, sure.
It is applying some of the settings. During that time, we can have Paolo in the BIOS. This is the first time he entered the BIOS for this round, so you have a lot of things actually apply. Clayton
This is Clayton's screen, right?
Yep.
So, playing 54 directly. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 437. Is that right?
This is 4.371.
Okay. So that's quite fast for the first run, I guess. Compared to the others.
Actually, setting up the pace for the complete benchmark. Quite aggressive as the first score indeed from Clayton. And it's a blue screen! Right from Clayton here at 26 minutes and 50 seconds.
That was the first blue screen in the finals.
So this final, these guys are fighting to win a ticket to the HWBOT World Championship final in December in Germany. This is extremely important for them because these are the best overclocker in Brazil. You can see now Paolo Yagashi trying to find out what he could do. Now he found the trick. He can apply zero and then go higher in the voltage rather than going from the bottom. He will lose some, he will gain some precious seconds doing that rather than going all the way from the bottom to where he has to go. Still, Joe90BR before that found the trick to actually type the correct number. It's adjusting the DRAM voltage now at 1.74, a little bit more, 1.76, perfect. We'll be setting up some other basic settings to not have the system unstable and move on to the next one.
This is Clayton again. 1, 2, 3, 428.
Four and 28 seconds. This is improving his score. He's actually making the lead even higher. It's at 5.5 gigahertz. We'll be now going to 5.6 gigahertz and 5.2 encore.
One, two, three.
You have four, very long seconds. Is that German seconds?
That's what I see. It's a lag. That's why you are faster with the blue screen screams.
Playing again at the same settings.
Okay. Same score.
Or again. Back into changing some of these. Oh, he wants to restart. Maybe going into the BIOS to change some of the other settings. During that time, Paolo is struggling to get into the OS. I think he went a bit too hard in the BIOS for the settings. So let's see what he could do for the next benchmark.
So Paolo is sweating. Overclocking is like work.
It is kind of like work.
Yeah, really, really, really. And then just imagine you have to fill your cans, your flasks, alone without having people doing it.
Yeah, you have to actually pour in your computer by yourself. You can get the flask from someone else, but you have to pour everything yourself. This is the first score for Paolo, 4.71. It is far from the one that Clayton have. But it is a good score to start building up on and improving over time.
Sure, he was just starting with 5 gigahertz, I think.
During that time, Clayton is already at 5.7 gigahertz, as you can see, 5.7. Pouring LN2.
And there's a blue screen.
You're happy you got this one?
I was faster. Great. Okay, Paolo. Paolo is playing. What is he playing? 5G still? Yeah.
Four point six 3 seconds for Paolo. This is improving his base score, but still quite far from what Clayton has been doing. There's 22 minutes and 15 seconds left in this final round of the AWBOT World Series Latin America qualifier here in Sao Paulo in Brazil. A new score from Paolo again, 4.5 seconds.
Yeah, he's raising the clocks very fast right now from 5G to 5.3.
It seems like what he wanted to have is safe settings to boot Windows and build up on that from there. So, improving his score again. He's closing on the target of on Clayton. In the past 1 minute and 30 seconds, he did improve his score by 0.2 seconds. And this is quite a major improvement over time, because this benchmark lasts for less than 5 seconds. So, every small step is important.
4.3. He's really good right now. That's amazing. That's great stuff he's doing right now. Now he's raising the voltages. Oh, that's my input voltage I use, 2.5. He's playing with the Encore right now. There we have a crash.
Oh, we have a blue screen from Clayton. He was benching. He was actually trying to improve his score as well. He was at 4.36. The same score actually at Paolo, but then it crashed just when he was trying to go higher than that. Is it Paolo back into the OS trying to have the safe settings again? And we'll be increasing, I guess he will be going for some of the key settings right here. Core voltage, 1.7 volts, 1.76 volts. Didn't want to touch the VCC in again. There's a question from Stepan Z on the live chat. What chip are they using? They're using the 4770K. They have to use the Seasonic PSU provided, HyperX memory from their choice, DDR3, and the Gigabyte motherboard from their choice as well. This is a new score from Paolo. 4 seconds and 271. Maybe we'll catch up on Clayton. 4215. He got him. So this is it. Paolo is now in the lead in this final run of the HWBOT World Series here for Latin America. This is impressive. He started very, very far, but step after step, he managed to catch up on Clayton. Clayton that is stuck for the past 5 minutes at the exact same score. There's something definitely going wrong with his system. He always experienced blue screen, and he always tried to reach maybe a little bit too high for what he can do. Oh, this is it. 15. This is it. Paolo is unstoppable now, like 4 seconds and 15. This is impressive improvement, and he's actually taking the lead against Clayton. And this is going to be interesting. If he continue like this, and this benchmark will pass. Yes, it passed. 4.15.
Great.
That's a very small improvement.
Cool. We are at 5.7 gigahertz right now. He's really, really strong.
Again. Oh, seems like it crashed. Yes, it crashed. It crashed. Oh, so bad. So they are benching at... Paolo was benching at 5.7 gigahertz, a little bit over than 5.7 gigahertz. And yeah. He was applying some Encore at, I think it was 52, I guess. If I remember right. I think that time, Clayton is back in the game. 4.197.
That was close. Now he's trying again. Same frequencies. No change. Oh, that's lower.
Let me check the temperature from here. I think I can see them. So we have, from what I can see, this is Paolo going back into the OS. Paolo is actually at minus 109 degrees on the CPU, and he's benching at 5.5 gigahertz at the moment. Going to 5.3 gigahertz for the Encore frequency. Clayton is supposed to be at minus 111 degrees. Paolo will try to increase the Encore frequency as much as he can to contain his lead in advance. The blue screen from Clayton, sadly. Maybe it is too cold. No one knows so far. Minus 11 and 100 D. Paolo just got a blue screen just before this. The system have to reboot. Losing some precious seconds. There's only 16 minutes and 9 seconds left in this competition for to know who will be going to the HWBOT World Championship in December. So both of these overclockers are now rebooting the system. And so far, Paolo is at negative and 107 degrees.
My favorite was Clayton, but I also said that a new face would be really nice to the community. So now we have both. Yeah, it's really interesting.
I just got the information that Clayton is actually running at minus negative 160 degrees.
60 or 16?
Yeah. No, no, 60. I asked Peter to repeat. It was 60. And I can see from here, you see that it is at negative 125 at the moment. When Paolo is stuck at negative 107.
That would be the first Haswell I've ever heard that runs 160 minus degrees.
This is it. Paolo is benching again. 4.119. This is a score improvement for him. He's taking a little bit more advance against Clayton. There's less than 15 minutes left in this final round of the HWBOT World Series. I had to stand up to see what the guys can do. So I hope that the sound is still quite okay for you guys. Paolo's benching again.
407.
This is two times the good improvement in his score in this round. There is 14 minutes left. This benchmark is so fast that they can improve their score multiple times per minute. Blue screen! Clayton is back into the BIOS. He reduced a little bit the temperature he was aiming at. It was at a negative 160. Now he's at negative 125. Maybe that was the issue with the chip. So you have to reset pretty much all his settings. He didn't load his profile. Interestingly, he didn't save the profile to have a quick load next time he restart.
Maybe he has saved the profile, but just want to try something else from the start.
Trying to adjust the settings, yeah. But doesn't apply.
Yeah.
During that time, Paolo is back into the OS. You can see a big smile on his face. Maybe he's going to win the flight ticket to Berlin.
Yes, yes, yes. The smile is from one ear to another.
So let's see. He's benching at 5.8 gigahertz now. The encore was 48. He's increasing that one. And he's not sure. He's not quite sure what to do. Trying 56, so 5.6 gigahertz encore. Was not quite sure. This is the benchmark. It's almost passing.
Looks good.
A 0.02 improvement in his core, so he's now at 4 seconds, 0.056.
That's crazy. Going,
and it's a blue screen! So, as far as I can see from here, Clayton is still in the BIOS, while... Well, we have Paolo that is rebooting the system. So Clayton is thinking deeply on how to set the settings. See, now he found the trick to apply the voltage directly and not use the plus and minus signs. So from what I can see from here, Paolo is at negative 104 degrees.
That's quite good for 5.8 gigahertz. That's really good. I mean, we are talking about W prime and not a light benchmark like 32M.
Clayton is at minus 90 degrees for you guys. This is it. He didn't save any profile before. He's now saving his profile. This is something he should have done at the very beginning of the game. He's doing that only 11 minutes until the end. During that time, Paolo took a huge lead and is knowing his processor much better than what Clayton can do at the moment. Paolo is still in the lead. 5.8. Maybe he's going to increase that.
There's a blue screen.
Perfect. So both of the guys are now restarting the system. Clayton seems a little bit pissed. You can see him. Like, damn, why this doesn't work? Because he still have to get back into the BIOS. It was not starting, so he has to go again. And it is back at negative 120C. Paolo is rebooting as well. He is not even focusing on the system, like just... Yeah, this is going well for me. This would be impressive because this is the first time Paolo is in official live competition organized here, and he's actually performing extremely well. He did extremely well in the competition, in the qualifier, and did also extremely well in this final. This is quite interesting to see some new people coming.
Yeah, we don't have so much new faces in the overclocking scene. So we have had that last year at the OC World Cup stage at the Computex. There were one guy nobody knows, but he won. So sometimes it's really good to have new faces.
Extremely good to have new faces, and there's a lot of new people coming into the overclocking as the amateur level. The extreme overclocking is something that is it's quite advanced nowadays. People need to have a lot of knowledge, and you know that, Zenko, because you are the best overclocker in the world at this very moment. Need to know a lot of things about a lot of hardware and electrical things as well.
Yeah, I've studied some stuff like engineering. So due to my study, I know some things about electrical stuff, but I'm not that focused on the electrical stuff. It's just more like knowing the platforms, knowing the hardware, knowing processes, GPUs, whatever. It's just all about training, preparation, passion. You need time and a lot of time for. Yeah, knowledge about platforms, hardware, whatever. That's the most important, yeah.
Clayton is still in the BIOS. The system doesn't want to boot anymore. This is pissing him off. You can see it. You can see that on his face. On the other side, Paolo is back in the OS, benching like crazy. 5.8 gigahertz at this very moment. Adjusting the Uncore coefficient to 56, 2.6 volt for the VCC in, the VCore is at 1.81, and the V-ring 1.7 volts, 1.9 volts on the VRAM, the VDDR. Let's see, dying. Oh, did it crash, or is that just before the? Not moving.
I think it's a cold bug right now. Looks like a cold bug. It's frozen, totally, yeah.
This is it, trying to restart the system. During that time, Clayton is stuck into the BIOS. It's been more than 10 minutes now that Clayton didn't manage to reach the OS. This is really starting to get on his nerve. You can see him, he's really pissed off. He didn't smile at all. He's really like, what the hell is going on with this system? I don't manage to boot, to make it boot. What is wrong? I cannot find it. It's been 10 minutes. It's been one third of the competition that is trying to make the system start. This is so pissing off the people, especially the overclockers at this level, right?
Yeah, sure. If the system fucks up, I mean, if it's wet or whatever, you can't do what you've done before. I mean, he was benching at around 5.720. Then he rebooted. I mean, maybe I'm wrong, but as far as I know, he rebooted, went into the BIOS, and now he's not even able to boot. So there's just an issue with the system. It's not his fault, and that's what you really pisses off.
Clayton is still trying to get into the system. He did just switch off the PSU, unplug the memory, replug the memory to make sure maybe it was something else, maybe a bad connection or something. During that time, Paolo right now on the screen is still benching hard. He is in the lead. You have a nice advance on Clayton. This is going to be interesting to see. Benching at 5.8 gigahertz, 5.6 gigahertz, blue screen!
There we go. Good one.
So they are both restarting the system. You can see this is the the two overclockers and the other extreme overclockers with the judge Massman and Yuri and checking for the time. There's less than 5 minutes left right here at the HWBOT World Series for the Latin America qualifier. Paolo is back at it.
Right now, setting 2.5 input, 1.78 V core, and running at 5.6, 4.2, almost the time from Clayton. So, right now playing with Encore and the CPU core, 5.7 and 5.5 on the Encore.
This is going crazy here. There is 4 minutes left in this competition. Paolo is managing to get the system again. Maybe he will have the time to improve his last score at 4 seconds, 0.056. There is a massive concert going on right in here at the campus party in Sao Paulo in Brazil. That's going to be quite tricky to do the commentary. So let us know, guys, if the sound is still okay.
.5755. Now he's raising the clocks. He's .5796, almost .58.
Trying to increase the BCLK, the base clock, to 102. Trying to bench again. Will this pass? Almost. No errors.
No.
Oh, no,
blue
the score
screen.
Up here. The score up here, it was 3.8, but the blue screen completely smashed and didn't manage to have the complete score being displayed on the screen. But it was 3.85 seconds. It was a very nice improvement, and that was actually much more in the lead than what it is right now.
That was close.
That was extremely close. Clayton is still not able to go inside his BIOS. This still doesn't get inside there. There's definitely something wrong with this setup. Paolo did a great job at finding a right safe setting to always start and boot on.
He's always booting with 5 gigahertz, always. Clayton tried to boot with 5.3, maybe that's the issue? I have no idea. But that looks really strong, what Paolo is doing there.
And Paolo is showing a very a mature way of benching. He's benching always the same way, always improving the step in the same way. He's not trying to go full out at once. So that's it. 5.8 gigahertz CPU, 5.5 for the Encore. We'll maybe try that again and increase a little bit the base clock to raise the memory frequency as well as the CPU frequency.
And another blue screen.
Like some of the other pro overclockers are saying on the live chat, yes, you don't need to boot that high to do this benchmark, because what you want is to start at a safe level and then improve step by step until you have the right score. The most important thing is to have the right settings inside the boot screen, the right ratio for the memory and the right timings, and then you can go on with that. So Clayton Schenkel is really, really pissed off. It's been a lot of more than 12 minutes now that it's been like this, and there's 22 seconds left in this competition. Maybe that is the last run for Paolo. There's 15 seconds left. This is almost to the end. Clayton still do not manage to get into the system. They're playing 7 seconds left. Go, go, go. There's 4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2, 1. 0. And this is over. This is it. Paolo is actually the winner of this.
Congratulations to Paolo.
Paolo is the winner of this HWBOT World Series here, Latin America. As you see, the crowd is cheering for them. This was a great competition, guys. This was impressive work by Paolo, displaying an impressive set of skills so far in making sure that, you know, he was maybe late at the beginning, and then he climbed up the ladder in making sure that everything was okay, step by step. Dan Kopp, what was your impression about this grand final of the Latin America qualifier of the HWBOT World Series?
That was just great. I mean, the choice of the benchmarks was great, and the choice how to do the benchmarks in the separate finals, like a semi-final, bronze final, whatever. They had to draw it, and that makes it much more interesting because, nobody knows what they are going to bench. And, yeah, right now we have a new face going to Berlin. It's incredible, really, just amazing.
That would be extremely interesting to see what he have to say on how he did prepare for that and how it actually did turn out for him. So this is it. Could have heard the crowd cheering for them. They are now going back, take some picture. These people are all friends. These people are all friends. They all know each other. Dan Kopp, that was a very, very, very tight round. In the end, Paolo was starting so far away and end up in front. So much congrats for him. What would be your highlights for this competition so far?
It was definitely the final. As you've said, Paolo started with, I think, a 4.8. Was it 4.8 or 4.9 gigahertz? And he was around 5 seconds. And Clayton already had 4.2. So he was much, much, much faster. And we were talking about, will he get him? Will he get him? And yeah, he just got him, and it's almost around 0.2 seconds faster. So talking about W prime, he destroyed him.
He definitely destroyed his opponent in that last score. His technique was to really start easy and then to continue and building up all that. So guys, this is it for the HWBOT World Series 2016. Stay tuned, we will have the some debriefing with both Timothée Xiala, Massman, and also some of the guys as well. So let's see what we will have during that time. Thank you guys for watching this. If you like what you saw, if you like this kind of overclocking competition, follow us here on Twitch because we will be streaming all the HWBOT World Tour 2016 event, and we will also be streaming a lot of podcasts about hardware and overclocking in general. Thank you, Dan Kopp, for being with us and commenting this today.
Thanks and for inviting me.
You're welcome. That was a fun try to do. And for you guys on the live chat, don't forget you can watch all the replay on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/overclockingTV. And we'll all find you again in another stream quite soon. So stay tuned, we might have some debrief, not quite sure yet. And if you have questions, you can always ask them on the live chat. We like to answer all the questions for them. Thank you, Dan Kopp. Thank you guys for the viewers. Thank you for tuning in Overclocking TV. This is Truthman signing off.
Bye-bye.